Greetings, Guardians. My name is Bife here. Let's talk about what we're going to see at E3. Specifically, the possibility of a Cabal expansion, which is something that I wanted to go into a bit more. There's a whole plethora of evidence that there may be something going on Mars very soon, and I just wanted to do a brief recap of everything that we know thus far. Some of this is not exactly from confirmed sources. For example, take the Kotaku article that I'll be linking in the description below. Having said that, lots of it has been accurate in the past. The very same Kotaku article seems to have been somewhat correct about various different things that it's claimed before. So, I think that the majority of this evidence can be vouched for and is viable. But let's go ahead and just briefly talk about E3 itself. Activision no longer has a booth at this year's E3. They chose to downsize given that they can simply use the partners for relevant games. So for example, Call of Duty and I would expect Destiny will be showing off their relevant releases at the Sony booth given that there is exclusivity for Sony with both of those franchises. It's not entirely clear whether they'll be showing off a gameplay demo that's playable or not, but if they are, these things tend to be the crucible. Or if you're behind closed doors, maybe you get a sneak peek at an early mission. But what will they be showing in this? Well, most roads, as I mentioned, point towards a Cabal expansion coming down the line, and there's several features for this and reasons why. Given that, well, frankly, the Cabal are the race that they have explored the least in Destiny, Bungie now sort of has a lot of pressure to pull that together. The Vex were explored in Vanilla quite extensively, the Fallen in the House of Wolves, and the Hive have had both the Dark Below and the Taken King expansions to flesh out their backstory. So really, the Cabal need love. They need a new story of their own, and there are some interesting factors that point us towards that. First of all, I want to go ahead and point out this Destiny Kotaku article, known as the Destiny Malaise of 2016. So, it's definitely well worth noting that this is an old article, but it does point out a very interesting feature, that there was an area cut from the Taken King known as Pyramidion. It was a second area of Mars, and this is interesting simply because this gives us a potential place for a new expansion to occur. And why is Mars so interesting? Well, I'll go ahead and get into a few more details on that in a bit. I already touched a little more on some of the other possibilities for an expansion later this year in a separate video that I did, and whilst I did cover Pyramidion just a little bit in there, I think that the expansion details that I talked about in that other video do also potentially pertain to this, or could even pertain to Destiny 2. I'll leave that linked in the description as well if you guys want to go ahead and investigate that for yourselves. But why are the Cabal expansions necessary? Why is this going to happen? Well, first of all, there are clues that we can find within the missions. Firstly, go ahead and take a look at the Shield Brothers strike. We hear dialogue at the end of this mission from Cade, indicating that we've killed all of the high-ranking Cabal officers within the system. That means there's no one left. That means the Empire is about to lose its footing in Sol, and this means, obviously, that reinforcements have to be sent. Keep in mind, the Cabal are always going to be a factor here. Their doctrine, according to the law, dictates that there is no way they can retreat. Cabal legions are technically exiled from the Empire until they actually complete their mission and return victorious. If they don't return victorious, they can't return at all. They are simply exiled and killed. Having said that as well, we see even more evidence of this from the outbound signal mission, which states that a distress signal was sent to the head of the Cabal Empire. No doubt, with this in mind, he will want revenge, assuming that it is an emperor and not an empress. Also keep in mind that with this, there is the possibility of a huge wave of reinforcements. On top of this, there are very good reasons for the Cabal to send reinforcements regardless. The Cabal bases on Mars and Phobos have all been destabilized. We saw the Taken decimate the base on Mars's moon of Phobos, and the Fallen House of Wolves assaulted and significantly weakened their base in the east of the Valley of the Kings. The Rubicon Wastes have seen frequent combat as a result, and all Cabal defenses have started to show cracks and crumble. This combined with the continued assault of both the Taken and the Vex forces, and Cabal numbers have been dramatically depleted. If you find a console within the first mission of the Taken King, you can find facts such as the main Sand Eaters' legions have been depleted by up to 60%. Those are some serious numbers. Reinforcements are required at this point if the Cabal want to ensure that their war effort is not wasted. And given the importance of the Traveler and the fact that there are so many other assets in this system, I think it's likely that they'd send reinforcements as is. And I would expect them to arrive sooner rather than later. Next up though, with Mars on the table, we have to take a look at some concept art. There is some seriously interesting stuff that we can see here. Most of this is from Dorje Belbrook, who's a concept artist at Bungie, and a lot of this stuff is unused, but the interesting thing about this is that previous concept art has pointed us in the direction of expansions. So, with this in mind, I'm going to go ahead and go out on a limb and speculate a little bit here with some of this. First of all, let's take a look at these four shots here. This is kind of the proof that I'm using to say that, yes, there is definitely a case for previous pieces of concept art showing off expansions. This is the Skyburner's Keep. Now, the interesting thing about this, of course, is it points towards what we saw in the very first mission of the Taken King. The Skyburners were the reserve legion of the Cabal force of Mars, and they were building up a massive mechanized troop force that would eventually strike further into the heart of the Sol system, potentially hitting both the reef and Earth. But the even more terrifying thing about this is that even they were decimated by the power of the Taken. So, you take this into account, and all of a sudden you realize that story elements are revealed through this concept art, which means everything I'm about to show you is even more important. First of all, let's go ahead and take a look at these images that I'm going to be cycling through on the screen. These massive machines left in the sand are concept art that have been around for quite some time by Dorje Belbrook, and it's entirely plausible that these relate to the Pyramidion area of Mars. So let's go ahead and just analyze why the hell there would be machines of this nature in the first place. Personally, I don't know about you guys, but for me, the first thing that comes to mind is the warmind. You see, every single planet within our system had a warmind attached to it. This is something that you can see with Rasputin on Earth. The warmind of Mars was known, as far as we know, as Charlemagne. This relates back to lore that was given to us very, very long ago before the game even released. And the interesting thing about Charlemagne is the fact that, as a warmind, we don't know what their capabilities were. Interestingly enough, the warminds are given very broad descriptions as defense constructs, and the cool thing is that we know their weaponry was exceptionally powerful. Take a look at this little piece of grimoire here that describes literally Rasputin melting Vex and Cabal, just testing the arsenal of Mars that Charlemagne would have had access to. The interesting thing about that, then, is that we still don't know what's fully going on because Rasputin is still learning to use these systems. They are still being powered up and still being worked into proper order again. With all this in mind, it's not too out of the question to think that the warmind may have had massive mechanized units at their disposal, such as these giants left in the sand. As for whether we'll be able to actually explore these, whether we'll see these in the expansion, of course it's not entirely clear. But if this is one of the warmind's premier defenses, then it's entirely possible that we'll be able to explore inside one, reactivate one, and maybe even pilot one. But that's really kind of a pipe dream at this point, and of course, all of this is unconfirmed. On top of this, we see just a lot more concept art of Mars in general. All of these areas are from Dorje Belbrook's art station page, and the amazing thing about this is it shows off areas of Mars that we genuinely haven't seen before. There are small bits of architecture worked into the side of these cliffs, for example, and there are even entire reservoirs with canyons moving through them that look as though they're underground cities. And the amazing thing about this is that in terms of technology, this makes a lot of sense. The wind currents that you get through those particular valleys that you have going through those massive underground cities, they serve a purpose. They allow regulatory airflow, and it means that in the hot deserts of Mars, you actually get cool winds blowing through them because they create air tunnels. There is real science behind this, and the cool thing about that is that it also means there's an underground city which potentially we could explore. If you haven't, again, watched that other video that I talked about, you'll want to go ahead and check out the Barkan Dune set of armor for the Warlock, because that in particular pertains quite neatly to lots of the stuff that's referenced within these photographs. Next up though, let's go ahead and just consider the other possibilities. Not only do we have these massive machines, but also there are other elements in play in the world of Destiny that really do indicate the involvement of a warmind. For starters, let's go ahead and just acknowledge that in every single expansion, we've had missions leading up to and hinting at it. So for example, we were hinted at the Sword of Crota and, of course, the Chamber of Night missions that the Dark Below expansion was going to be a thing. The Shrine of Oryx mission and the fact that we killed Crota in the Dark Below indicated the possibility that Oryx would be coming. Aeris was constantly whispering it. Meanwhile, the House of Wolves expansion was hinted at very heavily by the fact that many of the Kells in the system were killed on our path to actually finding the Black Garden, and then of course there was our encounter with the Queen of the Reef. You then take into account the fact that the Cabal have had similar hints within their missions. The Cabal have been using the Scion Flayers to attempt to access the Warmind Cortex at the top of the Dust Palace. They've been doing so with quite a lot of vigour, and the Scion Flayers are no small threat. They have considerable amounts of psionic power, even capable of rivaling some minor guardians, and they are capable of massive amounts of chaos. They're actually quoted as throwing their minds around like hammers, while the rest of the Cabal are clumsy and their thoughts are easier to pertain and read. This is coming from a ghost as well, which is much more easily capable of understanding the power of the entities that it sees. Then, of course, there is the chance of them being able to reactivate all of the systems from that particular Warmind. Now keep in mind, the Cabal are a society that are very happy to fling entire moons into planets in order to accomplish their military goals. They genuinely do not have any sense of nuance with this. As long as something that opposes you is dead, the rest is all really sort of side details that you don't need to concern yourself with. And if you reactivate a Warmind and make it work for you, the potential of that, the fact that they were given doomsday weapons in order to defend us, imagine if all of those guns suddenly pointed to the city. That situation right there is a disaster for the city, not to mention, of course, that it gives the Cabal a much better footing in order to fight the other forces within the Sol system. They could potentially take on the Fallen, finally reclaim Mars from the Vex, and maybe even make a strong concerted push into Venus and Mercury. There is a lot that could potentially be done with the backing of a Warmind, and of course this is to say nothing of the Jovians, which, as far as we know, are mostly unexplored aside from the rings of Saturn. And of course there are other locations out there: Europa, Ganymede, Io, Callisto, many moons of both Saturn and Jupiter, Titan as well, a massive moon capable of holding entire cities simply within one small side of itself. It's essentially a planet. Again, if you want more information on this, that other video that I talked about so many times previously is linked in the description. Just go ahead and check it out, there's tons of stuff there. But of course, this is the thing. You can't have an expansion that revolves entirely around a single enemy in Destiny. Even when you had the Taken King expansion, the Cabal were contesting the Dreadnought because of the crash of the Dantalian Exodus 6 into the side of the Dreadnought. The Skyburners hit back, and this gave us context for the conflict on the Dreadnought that we found ourselves in. And the cool thing about the Pyramidion expansion is that potentially we have enemies that we can find there in the form of the Vex and the Fallen. I do not expect to find Hive, and there's a very good reason for that. They've been overdone, they've had two expansions including the Taken King to themselves, and frankly they are a massive enemy that really needs to be put to bed for just a little bit until we can actually flesh out the other races. But there are seriously good links that we can make with the other races in the lore. So for example, the Vex naturally situate themselves on Mars because it contains the Black Garden, which calls them home, as the ghost tells us so many times. Also, there are some amazing potential possibilities with the Fallen, because not only do we have the scattered remnants of the Fallen House of Wolves on the surface of Mars that could be attempting to claim the land of Pyramidion for themselves, but also the Fallen House of Kings has a listening post on Olympus Mons, the tallest volcano on the planet. If they do have any presence that's close to Pyramidion, if the area does of course exist, then it's very much the case that we will be contesting the area with both them and the Cabal. The Kings are probably the most ferocious of the Fallen Houses, simply because they've been able to manipulate the others into doing their will. The Fallen House of Kings are like the Machiavellis of the Fallen Houses. They genuinely do know how to deceive and to conquer their enemies, and they don't necessarily even need to enter the fray in order to accomplish those goals. But they do have long-term goals, and their Kel, Servitor, and Archon are still to be revealed. And seeing as if the Cabal expansion is going to be leading into something else, it's natural that we would have an enemy in the form of the Fallen that would then be able to hit back at us in order for us to then find ourselves on the back foot. We need something that keeps this story rolling, and either the Jovians, which maybe we'll get to see a little bit of in the next expansion anyway, or the Fallen House of Kings seem to be likely candidates for a continued progressive story. I'd even speculate that maybe the Vex will come into play, because the Vex will definitely have strong story tie-ins to other elements in the world of Destiny. For example, the Vex will bring you to the involvement of Osiris. They bring you somewhat to the involvement of the Reef, given that they've had previous knowledge of the Black Garden, and of course, there's the intricacy that you can potentially find between the Vex and the Hive networks of gate systems and netherworlds. This is a way of connecting Destiny which is not necessarily seen by everyone, but when you can connect these dots, it's very easy to see how a conflict with the Cabal could potentially spiral into yet another power play by one of the races of Destiny. And this means that we have a story progressing forward. So this is all the information that I could potentially find about the Pyramidion area. Now keep in mind, a lot of this is speculation, so feel free to disagree with me in the comments section below, it's what it's there for, and I'm happy for you guys to go ahead and do that. But if you do think there's any merit to it, please go ahead and drop a like on the video. I will note that the Kotaku article, which I myself doubted quite publicly, has actually turned out to be true on multiple occasions, and if this was cut from The Taken King or was just on the development floor at the time being, then it's entirely possible that when we see something getting released in the next update to Destiny, the expansion that should be coming sometime in autumn of this year, we may well see this particular expansion dropping. And if that's the case, be excited, because this means there's lots of potential story avenues for us to follow. We finally get some proper Cabal fight in order for us to make something useful of that race and their storyline. And of course, there's the potential for something that I know a lot of people have been looking for quite some time, a Cabal raid. I personally can't wait for something like that. Massive shields being held up as raid artifacts, maybe even massive cannons that we need to fire at a boss. And of course, there's the potential that we'll either face the incredibly powerful Scions that the Empire can bring to bear, or maybe even the Cabal Emperor himself. Now that's a fight that I'd like to see. In the meantime, guys, again, if you like this video or if you want to check out any of the other stuff that I talked about, go ahead and take a look in the description below. And if there is anything that you find of merit in there, I am happy to situate you in a place where you have more of this content. All you need to do is subscribe, and yeah, I'll be able to feed you this as regularly as I can. But in the meantime, guys, my name is Bife. Per audacia ad astra. I'll see you, Starside.